Hi, good morning students. Today we are going to discuss about the magnetic effect produced by the electric current and its applications. Already in the previous lecture I have told you, even a single atom of any matter also possesses a magnetism, and in every atom the electrons are revolving around the positively charged nucleus, and due to the orbital motion it possesses magnetism. Also, due to its spin motion also, the electron will possess some magnetism. When these electrons are at rest means, they do not possess any magnetic field, they produce only electric field. But the same electrons, when they are in a state of motion, then moving charges will produce a magnetic field. And this was proved by Hans Christian Oersted. He took different types of conductors of different shapes and passed electric current through them, and he kept magnetic compass needle near to the current carrying conductors, and he found that these needles were deflected. It confirmed that when electric charges flow through a conductor, they produce a magnetic field. So first we are going to discuss the magnetic field due to current through a straight conductor. So this was experimentally observed by Hans Christian Oersted. Now in these two pictures you can see straight conductor XY. So XY is a straight wire. It is a straight wire. One end of the conductor X is connected to the positive of the battery through a plug key, and the other end of the conductor Y is connected to the negative of a battery. Now the plug key is still open, and hence there is no current flowing through the conductor XY. In such a situation, when no current flows through the conductor XY, can you see a magnetic compass needle here? A small magnetic compass is kept here. Its north is pointing upwards and the south is pointing downwards. And the magnetic needle is stand still. It is at rest. It is not at all disturbed. But what will happen when we close the circuit? So when the plug key is closed, when the key is closed, now it is a closed circuit. In a closed circuit, the conventional current will start from the positive end of the battery. See, this is the positive terminal. The current will start from here, and the conventional current will flow through the conductor in the upward direction, and it will continue its journey towards the negative of the battery. Okay, negative of the battery. So this is a closed circuit. In a closed circuit, the conventional current will always start from the positive terminal of the battery, and it will end in the negative terminal of the battery. Now when current was flowing through the conductor, the magnetic needle cannot continue to be at rest. Hans Christian Oersted found that the magnetic needle was deflected, and whenever the current was flowing from X to Y in the upward direction, it was found that the magnetic needle was deflected. Okay, it was deflected towards the left. It is deflected towards the left, that is in the anti-clockwise direction. Now again, the second circuit we can see, it's an open circuit and no current is flowing through this conductor XY since the key is opened. But this time the battery terminals are reversed. You see that end Y is connected to the positive of the battery, and end X is connected to the negative of the battery through a plug key. So what I have changed, what is the difference from the first and the second figure? In the second figure, the battery terminals are interchanged. Now I will close this plug key. Now it is a closed circuit. And as usual, the current, conventional current, will start from which terminal? The positive terminal of the battery. You see here, the current starts from the positive terminal, and it is flowing towards Y. And in the conductor, it is flowing in which direction? You see, the current is flowing in the downward direction, that is from Y towards X. And then from X, it is flowing in this direction, and it will reach the terminal, namely negative terminal. So now XY is a current carrying conductor, and the magnetic compass needle will be deflected this time also, But this time when I stood observed that the deflection of the magnetic needle was towards the right like this. It was deflected towards the right. In the previous case, you see the magnetic needle was deflected towards the left in the anti-clockwise direction. But in the second case, the magnetic needle was deflected towards the right, that is in the clockwise direction. Whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise deflection of the magnetic needle, you must understand that only whenever the current flows through the conductor, there was a deflection. Once again, when the current was switched off, the magnetic needle came to resting position and it was showing only the north-south. Okay, this made Oersted to realize, why should the magnetic needle be deflected whenever there is a current flowing through the conductor? It is found that only one magnetic field can deflect the another magnetic field. One magnetic field only will be disturbed by another magnetic field. So whenever there is a deflection of the magnetic needle, definitely there is a clue that there is some other magnetic field produced in its surroundings. So what must be the cause of the magnetic field surrounding the magnetic needle or compass boxes? It is one and only reason, the current flowing through the conductor only should have produced the magnetic field. So he confirmed that whenever current flows through a conductor, it produces a magnetic field surrounding the conductor. Because I told you that moving charges will possess a magnetic field. So when I say that conventional current is flowing from X towards Y, then the electrons are flowing in which direction? You see these negatively charged electrons. The electrons are flowing in the downward direction. These electrons are moving means they produce a current and they produce a magnetic field. So the magnetic field produced by the moving charges inside the conductor only is deflecting the magnetic compass needle. Understand? Okay. Then he wanted to find the pattern. Pattern means the shape of the magnetic field, how it will be. For that, he kept the magnetic compass at different distances, from the current carrying conductor. Okay, and he found that always the magnetic field was circular. The magnetic field was circular like this. Understand? So by placing a compass box, see here you can keep a compass box and here a compass box like that. Whenever you keep means the compass needle was deflected tangential to the circular path. Okay, so from this he confirmed that the pattern of a magnetic field must be circular. To confirm this once again, he did another observation. Okay, so this is another activity. See here, this is a cardboard sheet, okay, a rectangular sheet. It's a cardboard sheet over which some iron filings are spread over it. Iron powder, okay, powdered iron filings are spread over it, and a straight wire is passing through the cardboard. Okay, so let us say that the wire is denoted by XY is a straight conductor, and The end X is connected to the positive of the battery in series with the plug key. And the end Y is connected to the negative of your battery. Now, what happened when the key was closed? When the key was closed, all these iron powder or the iron filings which were irregularly and randomly distributed, they all were attracted and clinging towards the current carrying conductor. So whenever the plug key was closed, a current was flowing through the conductor. Due to that, immediately what happened to the iron filings in the surrounding region? They all were attracted towards the wire XY, and they form a beautiful pattern like this. They arranged themselves in a regular pattern like this, concentric circles. Okay, so all these iron filings arranged themselves in concentric circles. So this confirmed that the pattern of the magnetic field around a straight conductor carrying current are concentric circles. And once again, whether these circles are clockwise field or anti-clockwise field, he wanted to confirm. And for that, he again uh, he passed the current in the upward direction through one conductor and in the downward direction through the other conductor by placing the compass needle. Okay, compass needle. So whenever the current was flowing in the upward direction through the conductor XY, the compass needle was deflected in the anti-clockwise direction. And whenever the compass box was deflected in the downward direction, that is when the current is flowing in the downward direction through this conductor, okay, so this is X and this is Y. Now the current is flowing in the downward direction. So when the compass needle or compass box is placed, means this time the tangents were in the downward direction. Okay, so here very clearly these observations confirmed that whenever the current was flowing in the upward direction through the conductor XY, the magnetic field was in the anti-clockwise direction. And whenever the current was flowing in the downward direction through the straight wire, the magnetic field was in the clockwise direction. He confirmed experimentally. But to remember this always, there is a mnemonic or there is a rule. Okay? And that rule is a right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule. So what is this rule relating? This right hand thumb rule is relating two quantities. One is the current flowing through the conductor, and the second one is the direction of the magnetic field. Now magnetic field is a vector quantity, because it is having both magnitude as well as direction. And the magnetic field is denoted by the symbol capital B. B is the symbol for magnetic field, and it is having a vector symbol because it is having a direction either clockwise or anti-clockwise in this case. And the current is, in this case, it is flowing in the upward direction. Okay, in the upward direction. And the current is denoted with the symbol capital I. There is a relationship between the magnetic field strength and the current flowing through the conductor. Later you are going to study about that in the higher classes. Before that, there is a relationship between the direction of flow of current and the direction of the magnetic field. To remember this relationship between the current and the magnetic field directions, what rule is to be remembered is right hand thumb rule. Okay, so what is the statement of the right hand thumb rule? For that, hold an insulated conductor carrying current. Insulated conductor carrying current in your right hand. Okay, in your right hand. So you have to hold the conductor in the right hand. Okay, by stretching the thumb upwards. By stretching the thumb upwards. So the thumb should be stretched in which direction? Upwards. See, if this is a conductor, means how to hold the conductor is, we have to stretch the thumb upwards, and the remaining fingers should be around the conductor like this. This is the right way of holding a conductor. Okay, so you read the statement now. Hold an insulated conductor carrying current, okay, in your right hand by stretching the thumb upwards. Now the thumb indicates, okay, thumb indicates the direction of current. Thumb indicates what? Direction of current flowing through the conductor. And the folded fingers indicate what? The direction of a magnetic field. Okay, so if you take this is a straight conductor, and you hold the conductor such that the thumb is stretched upwards, so the thumb indicates the direction of the current in the conductor. If the current is upward, means can you see that these fingers are anti-clockwise? When the thumb is pointing upward, means these fingers are rotating in which direction? You see, it is anti-clockwise. Similarly, you put the conductor downwards like this. The thumb is pointing in the downward direction. When it is downward means, can you see that the fingers are in the clockwise direction? Like this you try at home. Okay, you take a pencil and you do like this. While holding the conductor upward, that is the thumb is pointing upward, means the fingers will be in the anti-clockwise direction. When the thumb is in the downward direction, means the fingers, folded fingers will be in the clockwise direction. So, this only is being confirmed experimentally by placing a compass needle or a magnetic compass box closer to the current carrying conductor. So, when the current is upward, okay, when the current is upward means, see here, upward current means this gives rise to what? Anti-clockwise field, anti-clock, okay, anti-clockwise magnetic field. And downward current means, in the second picture you can see that downward current means this gives rise to what? Clockwise magnetic field. So this rule is called as right hand thumb rule, and this rule gives the relationship between the direction of current flowing through a conductor and the magnetic field around the conductor. Magnetic field is represented by vector symbol B. B vector is the magnetic field. It has both magnitude as well as direction. And I is the current, conventional current. Conventional current means flow of positive charges, okay? That is opposite to the direction of flow of the electrons. So whenever current flows through a straight conductor, the magnetic field around the conductor is concentric circles. But now, there is a relationship between the magnetic field and the current in a straight conductor, I told you. And this information is very, very important for appearing in the competitive exams. Okay? So, this is for competitive exams. Now, the magnetic field strength, okay? Magnetic field strength or intensity, magnetic field strength is denoted by the symbol B. Okay, magnetic field strength is denoted by the capital B, and it is found to be proportional to, okay, the current flowing through the conductor. The current flowing through the conductor, and it is also proportional, inversely proportional to the distance of the point. You see here, first at a smaller distance, at a shorter distance, a magnetic compass box is kept. And here the deflection will be maximum. And when the compass box is shifted to a greater distance means then the deflection will be little lesser than the previous case. Then further, if you increase the distance means at a far off distance from the current carrying conductor, its influence will go on decreasing continuously. So it is inversely proportional to the distance of the point, okay? So these are the two factors on which the strength of the magnetic field depends. What is the first factor I told you? The strength of the magnetic field is directly proportional to the current flowing through the conductor. So if you increase the current, means the strength of the magnetic field also will increase. Then it is inversely proportional to the distance of the point where you are measuring the strength of the field. So when you increase the distance, means strength will get decreased. So B is found to be proportional to I by A, or B is equal to mu naught I by 2 pi into A. Okay. So this mu naught is a constant. This is a constant of proportionality. Mu naught is called as a constant of proportionality. Here mu naught by 2 pi also can be considered as a constant of proportionality, inside which mu naught is also a constant. You can say that mu naught by 2 pi itself is a constant of proportionality only, okay? Proportionality, where once again mu naught is a constant which is called by the name magnetic permeability, okay? So this is a permeability. Permeability of a free space, okay, or air. That means if you take your current carrying conductor and surrounding this conductor there is a magnetic field, and what is the medium surrounding this or what is the material present surrounding this wire is the air inside this room. Suppose if you remove the air, means what will be present in the space is called vacuum. So that is called the medium surrounding the wire. By how much amount it will permit the flow of magnetic lines, that is called as magnetic permeability of a free space. So these are all for competitive exams, okay, and for high order thinking skill students only. This type of questions are asked in the NTSC exams also. So I am writing this only for the purpose of such students having the competitive spirit, okay. So you must remember that the strength of the magnetic field depends upon which two factors, means the two factors are what, the current flowing through the conductor and the distance of the point from the current carrying conductor. How does B depend on these two? B is directly proportional to the current flowing through the conductor, and the B is inversely proportional to the distance of the point from the conductor. So B is now equal to mu naught into I by 2 pi A. So here already the current is depending on these two factors. Now by introducing this constant, I find that the B also depends on the medium. So the third factor on which the strength of the magnetic field depends is called as the medium. Medium, in which medium the wire is kept, whether it is in air or vacuum or in water or in any other material. Understand? Okay, my dear students, I hope you must have understood. Once again, I want to have a small recap of this. So whenever current is flowing through a straight conductor, means the shape or pattern of the magnetic field is circular, concentric circular loops. And if the current is flowing in the upward direction, means the direction of the magnetic field will be anticlockwise. And when the current is flowing in the downward direction, means the direction of the magnetic field will be clockwise. To remember the relationship between the current direction and the direction of magnetic field, which rule is being used is called the right hand thumb rule. Some other rules are also there in the later classes you will be studying. Right hand corkscrew rule and all. Okay, Ampere's swimming rule, like that many rules are there. But in your textbook you are going to study what? Right hand thumb rule. So what is the statement according to the right hand thumb rule? When you hold a insulated conductor carrying current, okay, in your right hand, such that the thumb is pointed upwards and the fingers are folding around the conductor. Now the thumb indicates which quantity? Okay, thumb indicates the direction of the current flowing through the conductor, and the folded fingers indicate which quantity? The direction of the magnetic field around the conductor. Okay, you will see you in the next topic.